Start with the basics of digital marketing in terms of what digital marketing is and why do companies utilize it. So typically, I mean, giving you, I would give my background. I started my career post my MBA. I was an engineer. Then I did my MBA and did work in corporate strategy. Then I did work as a brand manager. And then eventually I landed up in digital marketing, and I have been doing so for the last 3 years now. And I've worked in US MNC as well, online traveler aggregator, which is very similar to Make My Trip of India. And as well as Indian organizations, I was working with Room, and right now I lead the overall global web performance marketing for OYO. And so in terms of digital marketing, I mean, overall, over the period of time, why it has become important, what I saw offline versus online marketing, both in terms of career and why is it important for organizations, is basically in digital marketing, you have got the... in digital marketing, you typically... So when you look at the overall offline versus online marketing mix, so most of the offline marketing is typically which happens at one point of time. You have got TV ads and you have got radio advertising, billboards and everything. But you can't actually see the effect of it in near real time. And with our paradigm shift in terms of the users, the way it has been from offline to online, and I think in India every year, more than 10 crore of smartphones are sold, and with the data services being so cheap. So most of the users have moved online. And even while people are owning offline stores, but they still advertise online, and you can actually, the technology has become so advanced that you actually can track your user who is online and whether he has visited your store or not. So to this level, and that's where you fine tune your advertising. And digital marketing is a lot more data driven, a lot more real time than offline marketing. And there are various tools which are utilized in digital marketing, which is primarily Google and non-Google tools. So, yeah. So typically in digital marketing is like first, it operates in two parts. So one is the brand and the other is, I mean, brand, obviously all of you guys would have seen TV advertising. So TV advertising typically is linked to sale, to sales of a product to some extent. For example, HUL launches a new soap in India. So it will go to TV advertising, and then people know about the soap and they ensure that they are supplied and the stock is available in the store. Same with similar way in digital marketing, there is one aspect called branding, and branding is what you is actually a push channel. It's not a pull channel. So with branding, you actually create a brand recall value in the customer's mind. And that's where the customer can actually come and look for your product online. So branding, typically there are channels like, so push channel typically is your Facebook, YouTube, wherein a user comes and you actually show him the ad. So that is not a pull channel. And then we have got intent-based channel. So sales is a pull mechanism. Marketing is always push in offline. Whereas when I look at it from a digital perspective, so sales, I mean, here sales is more focused towards performance marketing. Branding is more focused towards brand marketing, which is primarily the push channel, Facebook, YouTube. Facebook is also performance, but Facebook scores more on sort of what do you say, I mean, on brand marketing. So basically, when you go browse on Facebook and browse on any other social media channels, so Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, so ad is being served to you. You don't actually go ahead and search for anything. But when you go on Google and you search for best red shoes on Flipkart, So that is one aspect. The second is in terms of search is always a high intent marketing channel. So basically, our digital marketing is divided into primary channels where you have got search engines. One is Google and Bing. Within Google, you have got Google search advertising, which is completely keyword based, and these are all paid marketing channels. So I'll mention the paid marketing channel, how they fare, and then the free marketing channels, how they fare. Then you have got Bing. Bing is another search engine. So these search engines, what they actually do is they actually index all the website queries that you have on your website, and they display the information. So that is an organic media wherein they display the information to you, and that would not have a tag written as an ad in front of them. But the moment, so Google, how does Google make money? So Google does not actually give their entire service for free. So they actually crawl your website data and put it indexed in their search engine. And then they also allow people to advertise on the top of it. So there are organic search results which do not come with the tag of ad, and then there are paid search results which come on with the tag of paid search results. So this is completely search engine advertising. And the same way is with Bing. And other than that, in terms of paid media channels, you have got YouTube. So YouTube is completely video-based channel, then where we have got 5-second videos, 30-seconders, and then 5-minute long videos. So all these are promoted through one single platform, which is Google Ads. And within search engine, I mean, Google is very huge. Unlike Bing is owned by Microsoft, and in totality, Google owns just 90%. In India, it owns 95%. Of search engine market share, and 5% is owned by Bing. And globally, Google owns 90% of market share, 10% is owned by Bing. And Bing is like Bing, Yahoo combined, and all other AOL and all those DuckDuckGo and all those smaller search engines. So all are combined. This is the search part. Within search, you have got again, through Google channels, you can actually run display advertising as well. So, So within Google channel, there is display advertising as well. So display is typically a push channel. So push, when I say push, I said that, I mean, you actually don't look for an ad, but the ad is served to you, just like a TV channel. When you are watching a movie, suddenly advertisement break comes in. So that's one aspect. And then display is typically that where Google actually advertises on other platforms and it shows the display ads to the people, and display actually generates a lot of traffic for many advertisers, but the quality of traffic is low quality, which does not really convert much, because search is like you go on Google and type whatever you want. So that's one. The second is in digital marketing. So this is search and GDN, and after that, what comes is search GDN, and then in push, a YouTube channel is there, which again is operated through Google Ads itself. And after Google Ads comes the website, which is organic search. So I mentioned that one is like your paid ads, which you see at the top. And those paid ads are generally are keyword based. So for example, if you're looking for flights to New York, or if you're searching for hotels around me, so if you're looking for hotels around me, you actually bid on the keyword hotels around me there. And so that's one thing. So you start bidding on that keyword and then your ad starts appearing. The second is after, whenever you look for a search result, there are four ads. So after that, the organic search results come. So the organic search results are based on your website content and your website meta description and title description. So meta is basically something Google indexes the website content, but it does not index the 100% content. So it actually knows that, okay, if these keywords are present, so these keywords can be indexed and then they can be searched, and that's where the search results are being shown. So that is again keyword based. So based on how much your website is optimized, how much the speed of your website is, so the organic search results are better or worse. Then is in terms of digital marketing, the other media is social media. So social media comprises of Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter, where you have got paid advertising. And across all these paid media, so you can actually look at targeting the users. You can actually look at targeting the users by age group, by their interest, by their affinity, and by the kind of demographics and geography they live in. So that this is the amount of fine tuning that you can do. And also you can look at user behavior in terms of if you want to advertise only on mobile, you want to advertise only on desktop, you can only you can do that as well. In terms of so these are the few things that you can look at. The second is in terms of so this is both Facebook, social media, and search engine combined. In terms of mobile app, which is mentioned here, and then there are other channels of digital marketing, which is programmatic. First of all, so programmatic, I think you would have seen Times of India. So there you see an ad which is running on their page. So Times of India in this case is called a publisher, wherein you buy an inventory on their homepage or the internal pages, and you place your ad over that. And Google actually facilitates that again. So that is another channel called programmatic, where you can, for example, if you have you have a company which has got a mutual fund product. So this mutual fund product company, you would want to always target people who are interested in finance. So then you actually go ahead and advertise on the sites which are finance centric and which have pages where audience interested in finance comes. So these platforms combined are all Google platform. In Google, you have got engines wherein which are like so in Google, there are engines like Google Ads. Then on the top of it is Google Analytics, which gives you the entire site and website data as well as Google Ads conversion data. Then you have got Search Ad 360, which is a Google product. So it basically allows you to manage multiple ad platforms, which is Google and Bing all in one. And if there are multiple accounts within Google, so you can manage it. Then there are certain automation rules wherein you can manage the entire automation rules where you can actually manage the entire budget pacing. So when I say budget pacing, if you want to spend at a certain rate on weekend or a weekday through Google, so all that can be managed. And then Google offers certain other features as well, which is for example, in an e-commerce, you would have seen Flipkart keeps changing the home screen of the app or the web. So that is what is called a landing page. And in terms of landing page, they keep on testing these landing pages through multiple platforms. And Google has a product called Optimize, which actually tests these products. So Optimize is where you can actually go to a platform and you can ask Google to direct 30 to 50% traffic on your page and A/B test those pages. So that is one. The third, in terms of digital marketing platform, what comes is newsletter, which is email. So email is typically for the people who have already registered with you and you have a database. The third and next is, of course, I mean, there is a medium through app wherein you market it to the users. So that's one. And yeah. So these are the channels. And typically when I was talking about all of this, then we kind of segregated the paid marketing, which is pay-per-click, display ad, video ad, social media. Email marketing is also paid marketing, but there are companies who have their own email tool and they kind of, this is sort of a free channel for them. Mobile marketing, again, this is like you have got mobile apps where, and these mobile apps can be targeted through Google Display Network. So you can run display ads on mobile app and you can have a certain ticker and that's where you can advertise. And within the mobile app also, there are certain alliances and partnerships. For example, if you go to a Ixigo app, you will find a few more apps listed on their platform. And those apps are like similar to have paid money to Ixigo. Why? Because Ixigo is, by the way, travel booking app in India. And why? Because they generate a certain amount of relevant traffic, travel domain traffic. And that's where many other players are willing to pay that money for that traffic. Then is organic marketing. So organic is direct traffic. Direct is actually people who go to the browser and type your website. And SEO, what I mentioned is the most basic and fundamental thing is in SEO is like your meta tags and meta title, meta description. So these are like the title and description of the website or the different pages of your website. So this is basically a description of the product that you are selling and a very generic keyword. For example, you might not go and look for a football shoes wherein it has got spike, but you look for running shoes if you are a jogger. So running shoes, if you go to the Nike site and go to their running shoes page, so if you just look at the meta tag and meta title, so there is, you can just press Control I to look at their site code and wherein you can see their meta tag and meta title, and you can actually see and search for meta, then you can see that they would have put the most generic keyword as the meta search keyword, because that's where the most of the searches happen and that's where Google kind of gives a higher rank. And of course, there are a lot of other factors, page speed and everything, which come into picture. So these are the channels. And in terms of why digital marketing is important, why? Because it gives you immediate reach. For example, I remember we were launching OYO in US and UK market. So typically it was more like we did not really know that what sort of markets, what sort of customers are there, and would people know my brand. So how to get my brand visible in those markets was like, first was, where do the people actually spend most of the time on? Mostly on their mobile devices or their desktop. So for mobile devices, we kind of targeted some ads wherein first was the branding ad. Nobody would come and buy a product if they really don't know your brand. In case you are, I mean, it is a commodity product like a petrol or maybe any commodity product where brand does not really matter. But when you go and stay in a hotel, you really look at the hotel brand, its customer service, customer experience, and the entire background. So that's where you get some influencers who speak for you. All of you, I think, must be aware of TikTok. So that is again a platform for digital marketing. The similar way YouTube is a platform, but YouTube, you do not really market the entire thing yourself. You do not create an ad. In the initial days, when you want to get more and more people to your platform, you actually go ahead and engage some influencers and you let those people speak for you. So that's one. So that is why I think in terms of reach, the humongous amount of reach it gives to you, that is very important. The second is in terms of measurability. So the measurability it gives to you is very, very, is quite real time. And if you run a campaign today, if you start a campaign today, but that's not, tomorrow you won't be able to see the entire structure. So entire performance. So it will take at least 7 days to 10 days for your campaign to perform. But at least if I'm increasing my budgets today, tomorrow I'll be able to see a what amount of conversions that I have. And typically it also depends on the product buying life cycle. For example, online, you may buy a low engagement product, but you may have a certain buying cycle or buying criteria. For example, if you can't buy a 50,000 rupees TV just browsing over Flipkart, you'll first research about it. You'll read in 5 places. You'll ask, you'll do a visit store and finally go to Flipkart and then buy. So this entire buying journey is a longer period, and whenever we start a campaign, we have to take all of this into account. But in a running account, it all of it is like ongoing. So and so this is one aspect. And of course, you can, and in digital marketing, you can actually control when your users can see that, when how much amount of money you want to spend every hour, which is not possible in offline. And in terms of reach, you can be as specific as you want to show your ad only to people who are coming on Delhi airport. And you can be as broad as showing the ad to the entire India on every, on a generic search. Like if I want to, if I start bidding on coronavirus today, so my ad would start appearing at the top. And if I want to target people only coming to every airport in India, I can target the advisory to all those airports in India, and I can just pinpoint those locations where these ads are shown. So this is the proficiency of digital marketing, and that's what it is. And in terms of demographic, and you can choose, which I mentioned already. So in terms of how to become a digital marketer, so digital marketing is quite data driven, and it's unlike, there is a certain amount of creativity, certain amount of marketing insight which is required, but a lot of data crunching, a lot of numbers you would have to deal on a day-to-day basis, a lot of predictive things, and a lot of experimentation, because digital marketing is quite evolving. And if I were to say from the time I started working in digital marketing, the way channels have evolved, the way many different avenues have evolved. For example, I used to just look at search engine and display, and then I saw that, okay, there is one more remarketing tool wherein you can have feed-based remarketing. For example, if you have browsed for red shoes on Flipkart, which is worth 900 rupees, then that ad will chase you everywhere for that 900 rupees shoes, and it will show you additional 4 items which is within the same price range. So all these are based on customer data, and it is very specific to each of the customers. If you are seeing 900 rupees shoes, it's not necessary that everyone else will be served the same ad. So the specificity and the uniqueness is what digital uniqueness of every ad is what makes digital marketing very important. So this is it. And in terms of So in terms of becoming a digital marketer, so what you actually need to do is, first of all, you need to understand. So Google as a platform is huge. So if you have at least, I won't say mastery, if you have a knowledge of all the platforms which Google runs and how it runs, knowing the backend engine behind it. So that's one of the first thing that you got to do. And also knowing the user behavior online. So how do you know the user behavior online? That's completely data driven. Once you delve into Google Analytics, you know that a user came to your site, looked at your content, clicked here, and then actually went ahead and did make a purchase. So So that is it. And in terms of how to create content and market effectively, so in terms of content creation, it has always been like the social media and all these channels are very, very effective in terms of communicating the branding and mostly branding aspect, lesser of performance marketing. So performance marketing is primarily Google channel and others. And also the third part is free channels. So free channels is your search engine optimization. And so search engine optimization is primarily, it is divided into two parts, on-page and off-page optimization. So on-page is basically whatever you do on your website, and it ranges from your page load time. So what is the page load time? Whenever you go type a website, your browser keeps revolving and the site does not load. So that is a bad user experience. And that's like, I mean, if that keeps revolving and your site does not load, it means that, I mean, somebody in digital marketing has done a bad job. So that's it. I mean, so that is all organic media, and it requires some amount of technical know-how. So SEO is completely different. If I were to break down digital marketing, paid marketing is a different channel. Social media marketing is a different channel. And within paid marketing comes a Google SEM. So SEM is search engine marketing, then social media marketing. Then you have got SEO, which is search engine optimization, SEO, and then there is something called meta channel, which is very relevant to travel industry. If all of you, any of you would have browsed sites like Kayak, Booking.com, Priceline. So they are like a search engine of the search engine. So even Make My Trip goes and lists on Kayak and Priceline, and the hotel in your locality might go list on Make My Trip. So it is like Make My Trip is already a search engine, and then again it is an aggregator of an aggregator. So that's how meta search is. And then we have got affiliate marketing. So affiliate is like I have a network of publishers, and I say somebody like Times of India or these sites, and I have that ability to advertise on their site. I have a collection of publishers, and I'll put your ad on their sites, and I'll get inventory and conversions from there. And the last part is the marketing analytics. So marketing analytics is typically like your entire marketing analytics piece, wherein it covers Google analytics and all other channels. And some companies go ahead and use marketing analytics tools such as Adobe Analytics, which is named as Omniture. Some people use Google Analytics, and then there are many other tools as well. So this typically, I mean, is, I don't know why the screen is not working. Yeah. So this typically is it. And I would not comment on the average salaries, but yes, digital marketing as a career is very lucrative. And in terms of overall demand in the market, that's very high, because it's a new field. And then every new company who are operating are into digital marketing, and they want to progress there. So that's, I mean, this is one of the skills to have, and that's good to have skill. So that's it, I think, for an introduction and for the basic background. This is it from my end, and if there are questions, we have 10-15 minutes, we can just wrap it up post that. Suraj. You can type the questions, I'll answer that. Visual content. What do you mean by visual content? I mean, Google Analytics and all, I mean, these are all configured by the organizations. I cannot reveal them to you. If you really want to experience the platform of Google Ads and Google Analytics, you have a Gmail ID. Google offers a free service wherein you can go and register. You can create a website of your own and look at all these platforms. Inbound is basically so outbound is something which we do from inside the company to outside. So outbound marketing is completely your paid marketing and Google channels. Inbound is when you have the customer data. So email is an inbound marketing channel. Affiliate marketing, basically, for example, all of you must have bought a pizza coupon from Coupon Dunya or Coupon Raja or whatever site. Even I do it sometimes. Now, I mean, whenever I have time, I search for discounts, and So these are affiliate partners of Domino's. So Domino's generates a certain sale online. Domino's generates a certain sales through other media. But this is a tie-up with Coupon Dunia, wherein they give additional sales. So for example, from Google, your cost per acquisition is 20 rupees. What we do is generally for a tie-up with Coupon Dunia, we give 5 rupees to Coupon Dunia and 10 rupees as a customer discount, and the company still ends up making 5 rupees. But affiliate as a channel is not that huge. It cannot be scaled up at such a level as Google can be. Digital marketing manager is a good profile. From that, all profile are paid less. No, I mean, this is up to you. See, there are nothing. There is nothing like you make money based on profile. It is always based on a personal skill set, and of course, based on the hard work that you put in and the industry market dynamics. Everything adds up to it. So any amount of salary, any amount of money that you make, that is immaterial of any domain. If I were to say that very honestly, it is all up to the person who is handling it, and it is all up to the dynamics in terms of industry markets. For example, right now the economy is slightly down. If it continues, it will be more worse, so you'll make lesser money. So what does pre-sales mean? So pre-sales is not relevant to this conversation. That is completely different. So pre-sales is into B2B marketing, wherein it happens before sales, and this is basically the entire lead nurturing portion. And within lead nurturing, right from lead nurturing to creating a value proposition for the customer. So that is completely B2B marketing. That's different, not a part of this conversation. So after this course, can we do some small stuff like internships? Yes, of course you can. How do we figure out algorithms of various platforms like Facebook? If we get an idea of the best time to post on FB, how do we approach? Okay, so there's no such. So all these platforms are like very high on machine learning. You can't figure out their algorithm. If you figure out their algorithm, you will surpass them in terms of spending. But then the best way to use the platform, the best features they offer, and how do you optimize on that feature is basically completely data driven. It has nothing to do with you. You cannot figure out Google's algorithm. Nobody can. Even I can't. But then once you start using the platform, once you start using the feature, you can optimize. What are the key elements to optimize the conversion rate in PPC, pay-per-click? So to optimize the conversion rate, basically what we do is, this is a very specific question, but then we can actually look at parsing out the non-converting spend. We can actually look at our audience targeting. If we have got manual CPC running into our account, there are certain bidding strategies. So we can change them to automated bidding strategy. And then there are certain other best practices to follow. So it's quite in depth. Yeah. Blog or website, which one is best for export business? Of course, website. Blog is just an informative piece of content. What is a funnel? So funnel is basically if you look at the funnel, there are people who come at the top of the funnel. So these would be just browsers. For example, if you go to a shopping mall and you are just doing a window shopping. So in a window shopping, you don't buy. Then you like some clothes, and then you go to the shopping mall, same store next time. You think that you have a budget which is 2,000 rupees of a shirt or a dress. You actually go ahead and buy it. So initially you are at the top of the funnel, wherein you are just browsing, evaluating, and you are not making a buying decision. Second time you are visiting, you are at the lower funnel and at the verge of conversion. So that is it. What is the difference between B2B and B2C? B2B is business to business. This is what companies like Tata Group and HCL do. And the B2C is business to consumer. This is what companies like Flipkart and Amazon do. What can we expect from this course? So I think this question would be better put to the Board Infinity team in terms of course, but I can tell you what you can expect from digital marketing course. It's like, so this is not like some sort of gyan session which you get, but it is a hands-on experience. And if you don't have a hands-on experience, it's of no use. What is the customer value journey? There's nothing called customer value journey. There is something called customer life cycle and customer journey over the site. So that's basically your user journey from homepage to listing page. So every e-commerce site is divided into four parts: landing, listing, product, and checkout. So all e-commerce sites have got this. So this is landing is like your home page or any other page where you want the user to come. Listing is where you show him the product. Then product page is where you show him one single product which he wants to buy, and checkout is where he does the payment. Is it better to do a job or freelance in digital marketing? I have a job in digital marketing, so I'll always say have a job. So how do you filter keywords? I think these are very, very specific questions. Same keyword may have been used by other marketers. So that's where I think the entire bidding strategy in Google comes. So it is like a comparative bidding. If you are bidding on red shoes and another person is bidding on red shoes, so for a conversion, you would have to bid higher. It is just like gambling. So you have to always give your bid higher. And the winner gets the conversion. Instagram, there is a paid method to grow it. What devices are helpful in digital marketing? There's no device as such. You just need a laptop. Can we earn money after this course? Depends on how much you spend time and effort and energy to learn more, to browse through the platforms. Will you share the presentation deck? I think Board Infinity would do that. How many people currently in business development role can leverage the skill of digital marketing to succeed in their careers? So business development and digital marketing are two different ends. So I think you got to build your skill in digital marketing. And what is the average salary for a fresher in digital marketing? I have no idea. That depends on your skill set. Salary is not a function of any role, any specific thing. That is always based on your skill set, based on your education background, based on the journey that you have been through in your career. Is it good to be good for an engineer to get into digital marketing? Yes, I know I am also an engineer, by the way, way back. Complementary skills is to be expert in data analytics. If you can learn Python, nothing better than that. It's good for a startup. It's good for startup as well as organized companies. Every organized company have got an e-commerce manager. Net promoter score is completely different, not a part of this discussion. So it is basically something core marketing, wherein if you have liked the product, would you like to recommend it to any other person? So this is basically measuring the customer satisfaction score, and that and net promoter score is like, it is a Likert scale. I don't know how many of you know it. So Likert scale ranges from negative value to zero, to a mid value to a higher value, or it can be from 1 to 5. So you would have always seen this question. Would you want to recommend this product to your friend? You say yes, then it means that the product or the service has got a high net promoter score and they have done well in CSAT, customer satisfaction. How to grow Instagram page? So I don't want to comment on it right now. I mean, I can't give you 4 tips and then you can go ahead and grow the page. That's not the way it works. Yeah, it is over. Thank you, everyone.